Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu4Java. This is tutorial number 6 of Spring Framework. In this tutorial, we're going to see wiring. We are going to wire beans. In the last tutorial, I created a class footer for sine, which I moved now to my package tutorial 6 to see it again. We are going to see the UML. This is a class we had created in the last tutorial. It had a name and a place, and from these two properties and its setters. We also had a get footer for sine, which gave us the foot of the letters with a name, a date, and a place. And apart from this one, I created a new class which gives shape to a new bean, which has two properties, body and footer. Let's take a look. Body, which is a list of strings, a letter. In body, I'm going to keep several lines of the letter. I'm going to include the footer as a property also in the letter. Apart from the setters to fill in the properties, I have a method called getCompleteText, which is going to return the letter with format. It is going to iterate over the body, which is a list of lines, and for each line, it is going to put into a variable complete text. I'm going to put an enter at the end, and then I return it as a result of the method. In the main, it looks very simple. I load this context of this class. I get the bean letter, which we're going to see now how it is configured, and I make a system out print line. If we run it, we can see the result here. Querido Papá Noel, dear Santa Claus. It's in Spanish, but I can translate it. I would like you to bring some skates, the Wii, the PSP, an Xbox, and anything else you might think of. Thank you, Edu. The date, Buenos Aires, Argentina. Let's see how the object letter is configured and how it is linked with footer. This is all going to be in the context.xml. Here we have the definition of the bean footer, as in the last tutorial. This is just a copy which I've made in this tutorial. Here's the one which we can delete. And here we have the other bean. We call it letter in the identifier. It belongs to the letter class and it has a property which is a list and is named body. If you remember here, set body, but it's a list of strings. This is the way in which you can write a list in Spring. You write the tag list, which opens and closes, and in between all the tags, values you want, and inside the lines of our letter. And lastly, the other property footer. This is the new thing. I've assigned a reference to another bean. If you remember, each of these beans is a bean in the container. If we think of the container, we did it as a bean of the hash map. This would be the key of the hash map. And inside, we will have this type of object inside each one. Here, what we are doing is inside the property footer, we are assigning a reference to this other bean. Yes, we can do this in this way. Let's run it again. You can see it works. We can also Do it including a tag being here. Okay. Bean. Putting this bean directly here. This is how we do it. Let's tidy this up. Okay. The bad thing of doing this is that we wouldn't be able to reuse this bean. It's another way. See, it works just the same. Let's go back as it was before now. Ctrl X, Ctrl Z. A bit more here. Let's see if it still works. This is correct, but we now have a problem. The letter class depends on footer. As we had seen, the container was to avoid dependencies. The container was to work through interfaces. We should make this class implement an interface. I'm going to show you how to take advantage of the editor, refactor, extract interface. It's going to make all the work for me. He's asking for a name for the interface. I'm going to write the same name with an I in front. This is a standard used by developers. We tell him to extract all the methods, the setters and getter, that are all used by the other bean. Override. I'm going to uncheck it so that the tutorial is easier. Basically, what it does is to write some tags in the inherited methods. Here it says declare interface methods as publics. This is not necessary because all the methods of an interface are public. There aren't any methods private or protected. Declare interface method as abstract. They're all abstract, so it's not necessary either. I personally don't check it. As you can see, the interface has already been created. You can see that I have a new iFooter for sign, and it has already been created. It has the three methods. It did a lot of work. It did this. It wrote comments in all the override methods. And they have. If I had checked override, it would have put at override on top of each of the methods. If we come to letter, we can see it that it changed this. Before it pointed to footer for sign, and now it points to iFooter for sign. And we see that if you say either UML, we delete this from before. Let's drag it again. Okay, now we can see the new one. We tidy up a bit. Be aware of what it did with two clicks, a lot of work. It created the interface, it extracted the methods, and it made letter independent from this. Let's see if it works. Okay, great, it still works. Well then, I think the tutorial has been quite concise. See you in the next tutorial.